Good morning. How is everyone doing today? Welcome to church. And those of you who are here in person and those who are online joining us, welcome to Shadron United Methodist Church. Today is Gospel Sunday. I thought you were going to be excited. You're just looking at me. You know, I said that there are some things that some of us as traditional Methodists are not used to doing. We got to keep gingering you up until you get used to it. Clapping in church, tapping your fingers or your hands when a good song is going on and not just looking at the singer, you know. So I wanted to be free, for where the Spirit of God is, there is liberty. And I would like to thank all of you that are ministering to us today. We are so, so grateful that you have honored us with your presence, coming to lead us in worship. You're not entertaining us, you're leading us in worship. And there's going to be different kinds of singing. And so you are welcome. I quickly would like to thank all of you that came out for the Uptown campus. It was a successful one. You can see the pictures there. I just took different kinds of pictures with the ones that people close their eyes, the ones that are opening their eyes. But I just want to thank all of you, and thank you so much, Janice, for coordinating that very important service to our school, the college here. And I think the president and many other people are so grateful for that. What else? Any other announcements? Let's not forget, we'll be praying within the service during our prayer time. We'll be spending time to pray for the Stokey family. Last week, Jim Stokey passed away to be with the Lord. And so this Friday will be September 1, will be the funeral service. We're going to be celebrating his life. And so please come. He was a person of faith. He was someone who fought and fought. And now he's being with the Lord. And what a privilege to be able to be there when people go to be with the Lord. I told the nurses who were there, I said, it's a privilege to be there when a new life is born. And it's also a privilege to be there when life passes to eternity, especially when they have faith in Jesus and they know what their eternity is all like. So please keep praying for that family and for many who have lost their loved ones. I'd like you to be open and let's allow the Lord to lead us as we worship. I'll call on our dear Sister Sharon as she leads us in the call to worship. And Jack Isaacs, of course, after the prayers, is going to take over the service.
Our call to worship today, you begin.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's sing to the Lord, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God in his mighty deeds.
Praise God for his mighty deeds.
Praise God for his exceeding greatness.
Praise God with trumpet sound.
Praise God.
Praise God with sounding cymbals.
Praise God with loud clashing cymbals.
Let everything that breathes praise God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's sing to the Lord. Hallelujah.
Please let's stand together as we pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we give you praise, we give you honor and glory and thanks. What a privilege to be alive today, and we thank you. We ask that in all that we do, we welcome your Holy Spirit in our midst, that you will give us a heart of gratitude so that we can praise you, we can give glory to you. We thank you for all the people that are going to be leading us in worship. We pray that your Holy Spirit, your anointing will be upon them, that in all that we do, your name will be praised, both for us that are here and those who are watching online, that the same presence of God will be with them. We thank you, because we have asked in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Well, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Gospel Sunday, the last Sunday in August. We today have about 16 sermons. So I'm sure you're all probably going to have a stroke after you're hearing that. I invite you, the 16 sermons are songs, so I invite you to listen to the Word of God provided by song and music today. And so without further ado, if you would stand, if you're able, and join us while Joelle accompanies us in singing number 66, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven.
Oh,
Please be seated. Our first solo is going to be Jess Blundell singing playing and singing Look to Christ. Thank you so much, Jess. Our next performers are our bell choir. Not a lot of churches have bell choirs anymore. We are very blessed in this church to have not only a quartet there with us today, but this fall and winter, hopefully some more folks will show up, and the quartet will grow a little bit. But right now, please enjoy two songs from our bell choir. Thank you so much. Pastor Tunde, could you come up here and lead us in our joys and concerns and the Lord's Prayer? And I will take this mic if anybody has a joy and concern to share. Robin, this is mic one.
Okay, we'll just leave 1 minute if there's anyone who has anything they want to share. I'm kind of working with time. There are things, we have sheets here for prayers, but let me just mention a few, and then if there's any other one, we continue to pray for Randy Lawson, Jim Stokey's family, Daniel is back, Stacy is getting better, and he's in church today. So we continue to pray for him for recovery. John and Joe Haslow, past members of this church, whose son passed away recently, we'll pray for them. Kelly's mom, we still continue to pray for her as she battles dementia. A dear friend of the Catcher, Lois Johnson, who passed away recently. The service was Saturday. So let's keep praying for the family. And we continue to pray for Ruth Ann Cornell and the women of faith who have been supporting her. We're grateful to them. Linda's brother, Rod, is home from the hospital and recuperating, so we're grateful for that. Are there other prayer requests and joys or concerns? Your time starts now. Okay.
Okay, if I'm wrong, I'm sorry, but I think Don maybe has a birthday tomorrow. Is that right, Don?
Okay, Don has a birthday tomorrow. So before he sings for us, let's sing for him.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Don. Happy birthday to you.
How old are you?
Okay, somebody's raising their hand for joys and concerns. Sorry for the break in transmission of the songs, but you gotta...
Yes. Jubilee also has a birthday tomorrow.
Okay. Jubilee is going to be 12 tomorrow, right? 12 or 11? I can't even remember. Okay, I think it's 12.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
And I just have one concern. I'm not sure you mentioned it already, but Jean Johns, she's an employee with USDA. She found out she had leukemia and is in treatment in Colorado. And she needs prayers and concerns, but she's having a rough time right now.
Amen. Okay, one more. Going, gone. Well, we'll be praying towards the end of the service. We'll be praying for Kenny is a daughter to my friend, and we have already adopted her as a daughter of the Oladimejis. She's been with us since May, first week or second week in May. Where's Kenny? Okay. She's been in Nebraska since May, and she will be leaving this week to begin school in Nova Scotia, Canada. I hope I pronounced it well, like Shokoloko Bangochi. Okay, so we'll pray for her, and we're grateful for spending time here in rural Nebraska and enjoying all the best of it. We'll get to meet her parents one of these days. So we're grateful for a wonderful time with Kenny here with us. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we're grateful to you for the opportunity to come to your presence again. For the scripture says, in your presence is the fullness of joy, at your right hand pleasures forevermore. So we ask, O God, that the pleasures that we get from your presence will continually be with us. We bring those in need of prayers to you at this time, remembering Randall Lawson and Jim Stokey's family, as they've lost a wonderful man. And so we continue to pray for the family. He sent his greetings towards his last days to our church, appreciating all the prayers. And so we pray for his family at this time. Oh God, we pray also for Daniel and for Linda's brother, Rod. We continue to pray for Stacy Sweeney and those who are dealing with loss of people, those who are facing surgeries, including Sharon Davis at this time, who is preparing for new surgery. We don't know when it will be. We continue to also pray for some friends, Dell, who continue to face health challenges. We pray for the family of John and Joe Aslow, who lost their son, Jason. We also pray for the family and friends of Ken Garner, who passed away recently. We pray for Lois Johnson, who passed away recently, the family. We also pray for Kelly's mom, struggling with dementia and other health issues, that you will give her strength and your peace and grace will be upon her. We pray for Ruth and Cornell and all those women who have continued to support her. We pray for those who have been affected with the fires in Hawaii and who have lost loved ones. Please, may you continue to comfort them. We pray for our students, college students, and even high school and public school, and teachers and administrators who have started school, that you will grant them grace and strength. We pray for Jean John, who is battling leukemia at this time. Oh God, we pray for your healing upon her, oh God. We ask that you will give wisdom to the doctors. And we pray for all those who have needs. We thank you for those who are sharing their birthday, including Dawn and Jubilee, that your blessings will be with them. We pray for all those who came out to support the mission of our church on campus this week, that your blessings will continue to be with them. And those of us who have needs that we may not be able to mention, we cannot articulate those needs, we'll bring them to you in our hearts. We ask you to meet us at the various points of our needs, because we have asked in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Our next voices, Sophia and Pastor Tunde, are going to do a duet, and it is entitled, Jesus, You're the Center of My Joy.
Voices of the children, my family and my home. You are the source and finish of my highest dream. Oh, Jesus, you're the center of my joy. You're the center of my joy. And all that's good and perfect comes from you. You're the heart of my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus, you are the center. You are the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. Oh, Jesus, you are the center. You're my center of my joy. You are the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. And oh, Jesus, you are the center. You're the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. Jesus, you.
The center of my joy. Thank you very much. Now we'll have our first reading by Beth Wentworth.
Our first reading from Ephesians 1, verses 19, chapter 18, and Colossians 3:16. I pray that your heart be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people, and his incomparably great power for us who believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in our hearts.
And now Stephanie Baumgarten will sing I Surrender All.
This song is written by Anson Dawkins, Derek Clark, Eric Dawkins, Judson Wheeler Van Deventer, and Winfield Scott Whedon.
To him.
Thank you, Stephanie. Our next performer is our accompanist. Joelle Keith will sing and play a song for us.
Hello. I'll be singing Precious Lord, Take My Hand. I know we've done it a few times here, but I heard some cool versions online this week looking for a song, so here we go.
So much. And now Pastor Tunde will lead us in our offerings and gifts and the offertory prayer.
As we transit to the next level, get ready. It's intentional. We're gradually growing, you know, from the worship mood and the slow, we're getting to the fast one. So let's remember the words of Christ as he said to us, it's more blessed to give than to receive as we take our tithe, offerings, and different donations to the ministry of our church. It's time to give.
Thank you.
Let's stand together.
And now that you've just sat down, if you would rise if you are able and join us in hymn number 496 as Joelle accompanies us singing this pre-Civil War song entitled Sweet Hour of Prayer. Our next music is from Shawn Hartman. She is going to play I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light. Thank you. Thank you very much, Shawn. Now Janice German will come up and read our second reading, and after that, Lauren Stevens will come up and play the flute for us.
Good morning. I'm reading from 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verses 1 through 4 and 20 to 23. After this, the Moabites and Ammonites with some of the Meunites came to wage war against Jehoshaphat. Some people came and told Jehoshaphat, "A vast army is coming against you from Edom, from the other side of the Dead Sea. It is already in Hazazon Tamar," that is, En Gedi. Alarmed, Jehoshaphat resolved to inquire of the Lord, and he proclaimed a fast for all Judah. The people of Judah came together to seek help from the Lord. Indeed, they came from every town in Judah to seek him. Early in the morning, they left for the desert of Tekoa. As they set out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, "Listen to me, Judah and people of Jerusalem. Have faith in the Lord your God, and you will be upheld. Have faith in his prophets, and you will be successful." After consulting the people, Jehoshaphat appointed men to sing to the Lord and to praise him for the splendor of his holiness as they went out at the head of the army, saying, "Give thanks to the Lord, for his love endures forever." As they began to sing and praise, the Lord set ambushes against the men of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir who were invading Judah, and they were defeated. The Ammonites and the Moabites rose up against the men from Mount Seir to destroy and annihilate them. After they finished slaughtering the men from Seir, they hoped to destroy one another. These are the words of the Lord for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Oops.
Thank you, Janice. And now we will have Lauren Stevens on the flute.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Since you don't know what I'm playing, I'll share that with you. this is a piece for solo flute called "The Lord's My Shepherd," and it was arranged by Colleen Muriel.
Thank you.
smooth and relaxing. Wonderful instrument. Thank you, Lauren. And now the next three songs. The first song will be sung by Norm Martin, the second one by Don Foulk, and then you're going to have to put up with me for the last one. So.
The moon goes up, so we're not split up so far. Just before the service, Jack said, well, to be in compliance with copyright laws and all that stuff, we need to introduce our songs and the writers and composers. You wouldn't have heard this from me except that this song is in the hymnal. So I copied the stuff out. Now I put picks on, I can't reach in my pocket. So, the one that I'm doing is by Elisha Hoffman and Anthony Showalter. Ah, doesn't everybody appreciate the fact that now you know who wrote this song? But the copyright part of it is not even realistic because the song was written in 1887. Did you find what you lost? See, we're acknowledging it.
This next song is was recorded by Hank Williams Sr., and I had to look it up on my phone because I assumed he wrote it, and I was wrong. And it was written by J. Howard Entwistle and Johnson Oatman Jr. And it was first recorded in, like, 1951, so.
Take the cable off.
Yeah, that would have been goofy.
There's a beautiful home far over the sea. There are mansions of bliss for you and for me. Oh, that beautiful home, so wonderfully fair, that the Savior for me prepares. There's a beautiful home far over the sea. There's a beautiful home for you and for me. As glittering power the sun outshines, and a beautiful home will be beautiful home, a crown I shall wear, when that glorified throne, that glory to share. But the joy of that home can never be known, till the Savior we see upon his white throne. There's a beautiful home far over the sea. There's a beautiful home for you and for me. And its glittering power the sun outshines. And a beautiful home someday will be mine. A beautiful home far over the sea. There's a beautiful home for you and for me. And its glittering power the sun outshines. And a beautiful home someday.
So I Googled this song and couldn't find an author. It is a very old bluegrass song. I know the Stanley Brothers were one of the first to do it. It's called What Kind of Man Jesus Is.
What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Walk the sea of Galilee. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Walk the sea of Galilee. Tell me what kind. man. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Made the lame to walk, the blind to see. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Made the lame to walk, the blind to see. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. The sick, he raised the dead. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. He healed the sick, he raised the dead. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is.
Oh, thank you. Our next performer, glad to, I believe he joined us last year. We have heard and said the Lord's Prayer, and now Pete Butler is going to sing the Lord's Prayer for us.
It's just inside the. Actually, I'm not going to be doing the Lord's Prayer. I'm sorry. That was That was my mistake. I apologize. Although I think it's safe to say we know who holds the copyright on that one.
We're safe there.
Yeah. I'm going to be singing The Old Rugged Cross, and it was written by George Benard, who was a Methodist minister back in 1912. So.
On a hill far away stands an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true, its shame and reproach gladly bear. And he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. crown.
Next one I picked for us to do, it's called It Is Well With My Soul, words by Horatio G. Spafford and Philip P. Bliss.
It is well with my soul. Thank you, Pete and Joelle. Wanted to thank everybody. There's a lot of moving parts up here on stage, lots of instruments, lots of different people singing. Robin, thank you so much for running the sound for us. Did a fantastic job. And thank you back there in the booth for live streaming and all that you're doing back there. And it amazes me that we have so much talent in this community. So thank you for sharing it with us today. And now that Joelle is back at the piano, would you all please stand if you are able, and we will sing our closing hymn, number 526, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Good job. Stephanie, thank you so much. Can we put our hands together for them? With the risk of repeating, I have to run that risk, but I want to thank, especially those of you who don't fellowship with us here normally, like Pete, Lauren is gone. Thank you so much. Jess is there. Thank you so, so much. Joelle, thank you very much helping us. And whoever is online that has been helping to monitor the sound and sending us texts to Robin and say, oh, it's too harsh, this. Thank you so much. That's a great job. I want to thank all of you for coming and being patient. The scripture says that a merry heart does like medicine. So when you are happy, you're healthy. And so one of the ways I saw that even those of you that are very serious in church, today you smiled. I know those my friends back there, sometimes they're like, we are serious, but they smiled. So thank you so much, and we give God praise. Kenny, can you quickly come? Let's pray for you as we go. Thank you, Sharon, for opening the service with a call to worship. Maybe if I did, the old sound would just be messing up, but thank you so much. Kenny's going, so let's stretch our hands as we always do. What are you going to be studying?
Biology.
Biology, okay. 3 years of biology, so that's good. Stretch for Chan and let's give the blessings of this church as she goes to Canada. Dear Father, we thank you so much for this daughter of Zion. She was raised in a pastor's home and she had continued to follow the steps of the family. And so she spent time here with us, coming to Norwesca, helping, sometimes cooking food many times for a pastor sometimes. And we just release your blessings upon her as she goes. You will go there to succeed. You will triumph. You will win. You will be blessed. The favor of God goes with you. You will not come back with shame, but you will move from glory to glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Your going out and coming in is secure by the Lord. We bless you and we bless your entire family in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please receive this benediction. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Thank you so much.